What's up, everybody? This is the 351th. It's the one today. Make it sombrier. Today I'm working on this cave here. This is Zero's cave, and this is an entrance to the alternate dungeon. Zero's dungeon is an alternate gameplay style where you're solving puzzles more than fighting. So this is where you're going to go into this cave, and inside this cave, you'll find the first cactus pouch. So you find a cactus pouch, and then you're like, whoa, cactuses! You eat a cactus, you trip out, you can see the cracks in the walls, so you learn about cracks in the walls at that point. And then Zero himself appears and sets down a bomb and blows it up and allows you entrance into this dungeon. So that's kind of how it's going to go. Zero teaches you things. He doesn't necessarily have to talk to teach you things, too. What's up, Beep Boop? What's up, Pedro? I'm going to work on the art first because I really want to make these statues look a little more 3D. Right now, they're just like... There's some perspective issues with them, so I'll fix those. And I think I also want to do some scrolls or some kind of like runes on the side of the walls. Your soul hurts. Oh man, Krav Maga. Krav Maga. I call it McGraw. All right, the first thing is the statues. Yeah, I fixed game show. Yes, I did. Why, what's wrong? Yeah, it looks like it's working fine. If you're talking about the chat window, it's because, let's see if they finally fixed, did they finally fix the chat window? Remember how it used to be saying, oh, click this, blah, blah, blah. Looks like they finally fixed it, so we can go back to this old chat window like this. Is that better? Is that what you meant? Yeah, they got rid of that. Finally got rid of that stupid message. Thank God. All right, we can have the normal chat window once again, everybody. That's right. Okay, cool. That's good to know. Save that there. All right. Yep, they fixed my serial number. They finally emailed me back, and they're like, yo, here's your serial number. Give you your freaking serial number. You paid already. Let him in. This guy paid. All right, so these statues, I think these are the regular statues. I want these to have an offset Y on their shadow a little bit. This will make them look more 3D with their shadow just in the right place. Yep. That helped a lot right there. What's up, T? Let's try a little more drastic offset, maybe more like 6. That's probably going to be too much. Yeah, that's a bit too much. Can't go too far because this is kind of, it's a 2D game still. You know, these shadows are not going to look perfectly 3D or anything. So maybe 3 pixels. All right, that's good. Now that's a very subtle thing to just slightly offset the shadow, but it really helps the 3D. Okay, so the next thing I want to do is trying to add. Well, first of all, I'm going to go to these statues and I want to touch them up because even the bottoms of them are a little bit flat. They're not very 3D looking. So let's touch that up right now. This has been bugging me for a long, long time. Hello, thanks for the follow. So I think it's in common. I'm looking for common statue or zero statue. Here it is. Okay, yeah, all three of these statues. Make sure I'm editing the right files. They all got put in level. Okay. Good thing I realized that. All right, we're good. We're going to go in level. Zero statue. Zero, one, and two. Okay, great. I can set this up as a video timeline and make this export easier. That's zero there. What's up, the gaming artist? What language is that? This is the language I'm using. It's called C++. This you're seeing here is a custom script. Okay. Take off this propagate frame one bullshit. Later, propagate frame one. Most useless thing ever. Okay, yeah, we got that frame, this frame, and this frame. And now I can just easily export all three of these at once. Put this in the right place. And we should see those updated. Yes, on just three of them. Great, now I can redraw them. Let's make these look more 3D. Like this bottom right here, this top is okay. It could probably be thicker, but the bottom, it just needs some more 3D-ness. You know, it needs to look like it's at a perspective angle. A link for me, huh? YouTubers, contact lists. Cool. Thanks, Pedro. I'm going to open this in my... How do I open it in a Safari? Oh, here. Open browser. Cool. I'll check that out later. You see, right on. Thanks, the gaming artist. I appreciate that. Thank you. Okay, so starting here, let's make this look better. Fix this perspective. It's been bugging me forever. Oh. Okay, so this bottom, the top needs to be taller. Wow, that's a huge list, 1,400. That's, oh my God. It's gonna take so long to email everybody when I finally release this game. Dude, kind of dreading that, right? All of a sudden. I mean, just to do the alpha, I only had like 30 to maybe 30, yeah, around 30 people on my list last time when I did the alpha during the Kickstarter and all that. And that took forever. Okay, I like how this. This needs to come like at least like that. Oh my God, that helped a lot right there. Just that tiny bit makes it look a lot more 3D. Let's kind of mimic that same shape here with this darker gray color. That's good. Cool. One down. No, I customize every single email. Coming March 2016. Where does it say that? Is that on that? Oh, that's the Bafu. Yeah, Bafu's wrong. Bafu, it should just be 2016, man. Okay, so it's kind of the same thing on this one. Just giving him a little more perspective. You need in a this game perspective, you see a lot of the top of things. If you're not seeing the top of something, your perspective is probably wrong in the art you're making at this kind of game. So a lot of the art when I first, because I'm a pretty amateur artist, I just started making art a few years ago. I didn't really have the perspective nailed in this game until recently. I finally started sketching really fast with a sketchbook. So I'd take a sketchbook and I would draw as fast as I could, draw out this game's perspective, and then try and make a scene as fast as I could. And this is on paper. I don't know if it's just kind of more natural for me with the regular pen and paper, I guess. And then that really helped me. Some all of a sudden I had this breakthrough and I could draw all of a sudden in this perspective. I'm like, whoa, look, I can actually draw things right and things look at the right perspective. So ever since then, I've been so bugged by the game's older artwork that just hasn't been updated. And just adding the tiniest little touches fixes it, like this right here. All these little touches are adding up to make it look way more 3D. In fact, that's almost done. Yeah, totally. It is gaming artists, totally. Like the creativity of programming too, mixed with art and also with music. Music is such a beautiful blend of math and art. And you find a lot of musicians out there who are kind of like geeky, nerdy, math-y people. That's because really a lot of music is math. People don't want to, the cooler rock stars and stuff out there don't really want to admit it, but it's true. If there is such a thing as a rock star anymore. Oh no, I changed this. What did I do? Oh, there. Yeah. There. Okay. Now, fixing this one, this last one. What are my thoughts on PlayStation 4.5? What are you talking about, man? There's a PlayStation 4.5 now? What are they doing to us? You can create music with algorithms. Isn't that great? I'm so interested in procedural music right now. I'm going to add some procedural music to Songbringer. And it's not going to be very much, but I'm going to use... I'm using... what's it called? Fmod? To do that? What is this? PlayStation 4.5. A supercharged version of the PlayStation 4. Rumored to be in development. So it's like a 4K VR thing? Why don't they just call it PlayStation 5? They're going to make everybody, they're going to charge everybody $400 again. There is a mathematical equation for everything. Yes, yes, it's true. It's totally true. Every melody ever. It's all represented with math. Or can be. Well, they all are kind of droopy on the front. Maybe I'll fix this guy and make him not droopy in the front. Yeah. You're getting fixed, guy. Okay, guy. Here you go, guy. Here you go, guy. Come on, guy. What's good, guy? What's good, guy? What you doing over here? Oh, yeah, that's cool. Someone leaked it at GDC? I know. What's upgrade their physics systems to support steady 60 frames a second? Pedro, tell me about that. What are you talking about there with the steady 60 FPS? Is that something else that's new with the new PlayStation 4? Like, are they forcing developers to be 60 frames a second or something? Tell me all about this. I don't know what this means. I'm curious. Are you kidding me? The PlayStation 4 only supports 30 frames a second? If you're at 720 at high res? Give me a break. Really? I didn't know that. That's so crazy. Really? People are paying how much money for a PlayStation 4 and it runs at 30 frames a second? If they're doing HD? I never knew that. Kind of highway robbery they doing, dude? Highway robbery, man. There's this latest generation device that doesn't do the latest generation stuff, man. You don't need latest generation stuff. You are getting sleepy. All right, this pillar looks a lot better too. Let's save these out. Zero statue render. Replace those. Okay, let's see how these look. We'll only give a couple of months for studios to adapt their games. Dude, I don't know about this, Pedro. This sounds like a crazy thing, huh? That sounds like really pressuring and forcing developers and pretty fast. Yeah, those are better. Those are definitely better. Let's see it on a different screen. Little tiny bit of shadow underneath them is all wrong though. These all need to go up a pixel. Like one pixel. And that also means we can make the statue offset 4. Thanks, gaming artists. Appreciate it, man. Totally. All right, so the shadows have to be custom for each one of these, which means I'm going to draw this all over. Let's get rid of this shadow and draw some 20% black. Did that work? What the hell? Thanks, gaming artist. Yeah, I'm actually going to do a playthrough on the game later this week, probably Thursday or Friday, so you'll be able to see a lot more of the game at that point if you want to take a look. You can also pre-order it and play the beta right now if you want. At songbringer.com/pre-order. There's that. My spiel's done. I said my spiel today. Ba-bam! Check that off the list. I did my spiel. Okay, come on, black, 20%. Shadow, here we go, we got shadows. Now, just like a one pixel shadow. Whoops. There, just that tiny little touch will really help. And then this frame here, let's see the same thing. Oh, cool. Glad you saw the website. Nice, man. So, gaming artist, tell me about yourself, man. What do? You're making games? You're making a game? You're in school? You work? Free parking! RPG dev! 73 points, no way! Okay, so that should really help it look a lot better, because before with those flat shadows at the bottom, it was really messing it up. Oh yeah, that's better. That's a lot better. Okay, once again, I want to go to a different area. Yes, RPG Dev's like, yeah! 73 points! Here we go, here's a few more. I may have cut it a little bit short here on this one. I think that one's looking a little bit too much. Yeah. This one here. Yeah, this guy needs a little more. A little less off the bottom. Okay, so I was doing that so I could have some better looking statues for this cool new entrance for this character, Zero. Zero is this NPC character that shows up and guides you. He's like your spirit guide, basically. You start eating the cactuses, you start tripping out, and you see there he is. He appears like in some screens and guides you. So he's guiding you to his cave, and inside his cave, the idea is that you go inside his cave, you find your first cactus pouch, you eat a cactus, you trip out, you see the wall crack, and then he appears again. He sets down a bomb and shows you that you can blow up walls when they have cracks. And so then if you go inside the hole that he blows up inside the wall, that's when you get knocked out and you wake up inside the psychedelic dungeon, the sandy dungeon. Jib's left behind, and your sword is gone. So it's really interesting because it adds a lot more of a different kind of gameplay to this game. It's not all just about combat, which is great. You know, the game's combat, I think, is pretty good so far. It feels really great to go fight bosses, get through the dungeons and all that stuff. It's just nice to have a little bit of puzzling as well, or NPCs and things like that. So, I'm going to try a few runes on the sides of the walls. In fact, the runes that are on these little guys look pretty good. So, where is that image for, like, mountain cave? Oh, I think it's a... Save that. Code all that? Oh, you mean what I was just saying just now? Oh, it's already have systems in place for a lot of that, Gaming Artist. Yeah, a lot of that will be fueled with the story system. I already have a story system and story data and all that. So, you know, the story system will handle most of that. Like, let me show you an example story item. Here's my story scripts and stuff like that. So each one of these story scripts checks to see if it can run. You know, it's like, oh, hey, am I on the home screen? Have I already done the home zero? Okay, cool. Let's do dialogue home one, and then let's set the shadow for the player and run this animation, and then set the input lock, and then save the game, and then do some more dialogue. You know what I mean? It's just a system for doing all this stuff that makes it easy to represent with data, right? That's the point. You don't want to code everything every time. You want to represent things with data, so you can change the data and not have to change your code. Okay, so I want to open up. I think I just want to do overworld.psd. Yeah. And it's just like this image right here. Most difficult thing to do is make all the generic instead of coding each story individually. Yeah, totally. Yeah, well, I mean, this is a year and a half into developing this game, so the systems better be good by this point. You know, I've learned a lot of lessons in this project. I learned a lot of lessons in every project, every game I ever make. And so, you know, this is 20 years into me making video games, and I finally was like, dude, I gotta like really make things easier on myself. You know, what are the things that I'm doing that suck that make it harder for me to develop games? How can I develop games faster? And I started this project with that in mind, and that's what guided me to using an entity component system, to using behavior trees for doing AI, and making things as data-driven as possible. And all those things, you add those things together, you have a wicked, sick, awesome game dev flow. You become rapid, very rapid. You're swift and quick, man. Okay, so you notice I can't think and talk at the same time. It's all smoke and mirrors, man. It's all smoke and mirrors. Okay, so I'm calling this mountain cave door ground. I want this to be like mountain cave door runes. Yeah, learning from mistakes, for sure. That always helps. If you don't learn from your mistakes, you just keep making them. Okay, so I guess I want to see that and then go to plants. This is all called plants. It's called sprites now. Okay, and I'll draw some runes. Squiggly diggly do. I'll fix that in a second. I just want to see if that's the right, everything's like, you know, get this all lined up first. So this is going to be in common. Wait, did I just render it? I didn't mean to render video. I meant to save for web. All right, so sheets, common. Oh, damn it. No, don't do all, only user slices. Thank you. And not called Rock Zero. Damn it. Overworld, user slices, common. Save. Okay, so I want to hook that up in the game so it does that for Zero's Cave. That's going to be create stairs tile. Interest, home, secret, entrance. Here we go. If it's the entrance. Ooh, we might need to actually do, oh, yeah. I think I need to copy that over. And now it needs to be renamed. This is like mountain cave door, ground, runes. Man, that's a long ass name. Yeah, so if we're doing an entrance to a dungeon, we're going to do Mountain Dave, Cave Door, Ground Runes. I hope that works. Henko, yes, there's the diagonal movement. There's diagonal movement. Enemies can move diagonally. You can throw things diagonally. I had it without diagonal movement for a long time. And then recently, maybe 6 months ago, I changed it to be 8 compass directions instead of 4. And so I was, you know, I gave up the game kind of being totally 8-bit, and it's kind of more a 16-bit game now. But yeah, you can totally move things diagonally. You can throw your top hat diagonally. I can move diagonally. The reason why it looks like I'm not moving diagonally very much is because I'm using the keyboard mostly when I'm developing. I play the game mostly on a gamepad, so it looks like it's way more diagonal, right? With the gamepad, you got 360 degrees, so it looks like smooth, perfect movement, but like with the keyboard, it's a lot more chunky movement. Okay, good. So that worked. We have some runes here, some temporary graffiti on the sides of this wall. I want to make that look cool now. Let's draw a heart over here. Does that even look like a heart? Let's see if that even looks like a heart. Probably doesn't. I want to emphasize the heart over the head, the heart over the mind, the intuition over the mind. That's what this is mostly about, this character, the spirit guide and all that. The theme of this whole game is heart over head. It didn't work. Why didn't it update? What's up with you? Let's try that export again. It didn't rebuild. Okay. I don't know why it doesn't rebuild sometimes. Come on, pack those sprites. Keep it packed. Don't ever ask me to pack. Do it yourself. The script should work. Damn it. I don't know why the script just doesn't work sometimes. Hammerspoon just takes a day off every once in a while. Makes me do menial things. Yay, all right. We have a few runes to start with. Okay, yeah, the heart looks stupid. Let's do some runes. Stupid heart. Okay, that time it's rebuilding. Yeah, this is looking a little bit better. Just a little something custom for this particular entrance, this particular cave needs something, you know. Man, this code is wrong. All this code is so not data-driven, as you can tell. That's old code. There, that's nice. Just a little bit of that kind of stuff really makes something look special. You're like, what's that? Why does that have special stuff? And everything else does not have special stuff. Okay, I think we've come to the point in the stream where I'm actually going to go inside this cave. We're going to do some patterns on the inside of the cave to make it look sweet and custom for this particular dungeon entrance. Okay, so let's check in what's been done so far. This is, let's just save that. That's done too. What do we add? This file, cave, door, ground, runes. That's the one we need. This we don't need. Okay, make sure all these changes are good. I used a more shadow offset to make the statues look more 3D. I redrew the statues. I added some runes. Okay, cool. It's good enough. Git commit. Better zero statues and runes for... Zero's Cave. It really applies to more caves than just Zero's Cave, but for now it's just Zero's Cave that does that. Okay, cool. We got a little... That checked in. It's a good little jumping platform into the next thing. So the first thing, I'm just going to walk inside the cave. Well, first I'll make sure that it still has the graphics I just created because I did delete one file. So let's make sure that's all still good. Then I'll walk inside the cave and save my game there and then start working on that. Because right now it's going to do a totally different style. It does the 2 style, the Dungeon Entrance 2 style for these. So this is going to look all wrong, but yeah, good. The runes are still there. All is well. Okay, so if I go inside this cave, as you can see, it looks totally wrong. But anyways, I'm saving the game here. And let's start by fixing the style for that. So the style... why is it even doing that style? This should be negative. Okay, hold on. Let's see what... I forget what Z position this even is. What? This is area 0, 0, negative 13. So this is 13. Oh. If I go, I think it's where in the world where it's like setting styles for the swordless dungeons. Oh, this is like, what's that called? World text. It sets defaults. Oh, here it is. Alt dungeons 3. Alt dungeons. So I need to look for alt dungeons. Here we go. Oh, see, this should be doing its extra. Oh, it's doing its extra Z, but it's not doing its entrance Z. No problem. How do I get that? Oh, negative 10 plus minus I. Style keys minus Z equals style. There. So now it should have the same style. Psychedelic. That's probably wrong, actually. It needs to be cave. Yeah, we don't want this all to be sandy. Just yet. This is not the sandy dungeon yet. This should be a cave. Okay, let's make that a cave by... I think we can just call it cave. Oh, sweet. Looks okay, but it's like, it's weird. Because it's using too much sky tiles, but yeah. This is kind of what this would look like. Cool. Alright, this is a good start. Very interesting to see this pattern applied to this cave style. With the shadows not, they're not deep enough yet. But the sides, the walls, these side walls here, these are going to be a lot deeper, like 3 or 4 more tiles tall. But anyways, this is a good start. I can do a pattern for 0. This entrance cave. Okay, so this is 0, 0, negative 13, which means it's probably going to do pattern entrance underground. I think that's the pattern it'll run. So I'm going to my area patterns. These are algorithms. All these are tons and tons of algorithms to make the whole world come to life flexibly based on tiles. Yeah, there's an underground entrance one. Okay, so it's going through my head, like what needs to be done to this is that I need to throw this into another function which is a little more flexible, where it's like it can generate patterns and stuff based on lots of different data. This is kind of an old school system where I did these different functions for each one, and it means that I have to go put a new different message signature into everything. Every time I want to change and add a new pattern, I have to go add it to the area.h, which is just horrible. So underground entrance. For now, I'm just going to do the cheap way. Maybe I will go the cheap way, actually. Maybe I should do this right from the get-go. I can do this right. Come on. Constance H. Let's do this right. Pattern. We've got overworld entrances. Now I'm going to add some special entrances for underground entrances. So this is an underground entrance from... We really only have two of these at this point. Pattern entrance. Two A, two B. Three A, three B. I guess we'll call these U. This is entrance underground to style two, but this is the bottom. This is the top. Okay, we'll get that compiling and let's hook this up into all the proper methods and stuff. Adding a proper word, so we need to make sure all these entrance U U2A, U2B, 3A, 3B, 3A, 3B, 3A, blah, blah, blah. Cool. All right, so if we're underground, oh, let's get these fixed too before I do that. No, not that. Oh, yeah, I guess that works. We don't need any of those. Okay, so yeah, if it's else if Constance is underground entrance, the pattern, it's going to be based on style character. So I guess like, oh yeah, I'm gonna have to do the style character based on Constance get no what is this get it's like get z world get z world get z get oh what is it there's some function which converts an underground entrance into get level. There it is, get level from Z. It just as if it's an underground entrance, it figures it out for you. Same thing with extra Z. Get level. Was that Constance? Get level. Yeah, get level. Get level Z would probably be a better name. I just recompiled. Okay, so if this is... If C is cave, and Y is 0, now we'll do this. Pattern equals Y is 0. It's going to be K pattern entrance underground 3A. Otherwise, for now, we're just using the existing 2 pattern. I'm going to make this smarter once we have like a lot more underground patterns and stuff. This should do. Oh, this is P dot Y. Okay, so there. That should put some proper patterns. And then now I just got to convert it so. Underground entrance pattern, underground entrance. This is probably going to ignore these completely at this point. Good evening, Grim Gary. What's up? What's up? What's up? Welcome. Yeah, it still did the old patterns basically because it's always forced to do that. So, Grim Gary, I'm working on a special cave. This cave is where you meet Zero. Your spirit guide, here's what he looks like. So Zero is like this guy that starts appearing, right? And he guides you. So there he is on the edge of the screen. There he's appearing up there in the top left. He's guiding me to his cave. And yeah, I'll do him one more time. He'll appear right in front of this cave and he's walking upwards. And then yeah, you come into his special cave. His special cave is something that's pretty cool. But you'll see how it develops. Nice! Right on, Grim Gary. Did you do Ludum Dare? You did! Yeah, I saw your posts. How'd your game turn out, man? What's the link? Let's come on, share the link to your game. Don't hold out on me, man. Don't hold out on me. Okay, so I'm going to convert these into the methods I was talking about earlier. All right. Star Tribe. Sweet man, good job. Hey, so tell me, you could visit your home planet to heal up? Sweet. Shifting aspect. You can shift between forms if you have enough spirit by using the 1 to 4 keys. Wow. Okay, so you can shift your form. You got warrior form, thunderbird form, tortoise form, and crab form. Cool. Nice job, Grim Gary. Yeah, Windows. Windows only. Is Ludum Dare always Windows only? I forget. Okay, let's be brave and take this function completely out. And pattern underground entrance. Oh, okay, so it's everything. Oh, you can do board games, really? Wow. So I'm going into pattern, add pattern. All right, so we'll start with U2A, and then we'll go with U3A. Yeah, a lot of people said they didn't like this year's theme. I heard that complaint before. I'm gonna copy this so I don't have to worry about it. Oh, you had to keep in mind. Oh, you just adjusted it. Cool. So how did that work? Did you like the how it adjusted your game design basically? Okay, so this one has a rectangle strip of land. Let's convert this to the right method for each tile. Got this, we got W2 in X, in Y. And this gets more simple. Yeah, more simple. It didn't affect it much. Oh. Oh. Some of the sloppiest code you ever wrote, because it was so fast. Yeah, right. I know what you mean. Okay, that ought to do. This simplified that method a lot, right? That thing was a long method. Now it's just pretty simple compared to that. So let's see this next one. This one sets tile entrance. It's not the lowest area. This is the highest area. This game we're doing a rectangle strip. Capture H2. We're only using XD once. I don't see the point of setting a variable there. Okay, there, that's nice and shorter and neater. There we got pattern entrance U2A and U2B. Okay, so that means that this should be blank now, this pattern, because this one should have the pattern three. Didn't work. Let's check on what patterns are being set. It's got a little thing I could turn on that shows me the pattern for every dungeon entrance. Yeah. missed it. This is entrance YouTube B. Okay, yeah, it did U2 for those. Why did it do U2? Okay, let's check these other ones. Okay, U2A works here. U2B works here. It's just doing U2A, U2B. And the other one, which is world. So I think that was MAZ13, so I'm gonna set a breakpoint. C3. Huh, it's 3. That's fine. That's better than... Why is it 3, though? I thought I set that to be 2, or I mean, C, on purpose. In this very same file, world.cpp, I thought I had, oh, here it is. Level styles, alternate dungeons, here we go. Style keys. Oh, style keys, but it doesn't set the style car. Or did it already set the style character? Ah, I gotta see that. Gotta see it. Can't just guess. Okay, world, get style car. Get level. This should return, get level should return 3. Yeah, 3. Do we already have it? We already had it. Oh, it's going to return attributes.stylecar for Z3. It doesn't matter what the style key is. Okay, that makes sense now. I don't have to worry about exploring that anymore. Where was I? Style character. All right, so if C is 3, we're doing this pattern 3. And that should be blank. We should have totally blank floor in here in this cave. All right, good, it works. Everything is totally blank. This one too. All right, clean slate. Okay. So now we got this clean slate. We got the patterns ready, did things right. Go to the area patterns. Game shows eating up a CPU. Damn. It's making my fan turn on. That always bugs me. Distracts me like crazy. Game show. It's only an hour into it and it decided to just start using the whole CPU. Oh, well, okay. I'm just going to stream with this crazy noise anyways. Let's go pattern. U3A, we'll start with the stairs at the bottom. First thing. Second thing, I want to do like sky on the right. Maybe some water would be interesting to see in these caves. Ooh, that is interesting. There's a function called getTileStyle. Oh no, it's not getTileStyle, it's rocks to mountains. Let's turn that on for is underground entrance. So that's going to turn all the rocks into mountains and that'll look cooler. Yeah, cool. We got some tall mountains here to start. This is probably gonna break. Yeah, this is totally broken. But I guess it would get me into this dungeon. No, I'm broken. Oh, no, it worked. Okay, so I'm in dungeon 3. Okay, I can turn off area CPPs. We'll notice. And I'm going to take a little break, get some drinking water, be right back. What's up, Sean? It's crazy. Where is everyone? I don't know. Okay, so I don't need to be here anymore. Let's put the player back at negative 13. How you doing, Sean? It's crazy. You still crazy? Okay, so I think I'm gonna put the player here and focus on this area. But let me clean up these functions and check this in, because this is a good point for check-in. Pattern underground entrance is no longer used. Get rid of that. Pattern entrance really isn't even used. This is good. Taking out functions. Stuff we don't need anymore. We just want to add some water and a pattern. We're doing an entrance. Get rid of this function. We don't need it. Yeah! Method's gone! Okay, this other method was getLevel. That was kind of a really weak name. Very weak name for a function. This should be like getDungeonZ or getLevelZ. At least getLevelZ. So we'll call that isLevel. GetLevelZ there. Okay. So that's compiling. Let me check this over while it's compiling and I'll prep this check-in. I always do my, before I ever check anything, and I always go and double check what I'm changing in the code base and what I'm checking in. So we got this new rename function, level Z. We've taken out pattern underground entrance and pattern entrance and using pattern, actual patterns instead of functions, which is way better. There's a whole function that's just gone, converted to one of these nice, neater patterns down here. And looking good. Okay, I'm gonna commit that because I'm pretty sure that's gonna compile fine. Cool. Once again, it's always good to have as many commits as possible. Really, like splitting your commits into more smaller commits is always a good thing, right? You get one thing checked in, it's done well. You get on to the next thing. Do that. Do it well. It's the Unix mentality. It applies to regular day, everyday programming. Okay. So what needs to be done next is inside this cave, there's going to be a story sequence. And actually, outside of the cave, there's another little bit where he zero appears. In fact, I think I want to do zero appearing right now. Yeah, let's do that before we go in this cave. Stick here. So on this screen here, zero appears. And that's all in the function where create zero. This code right here, this whole thing, all that it's doing is finding the position for zero. We sail to the FAP cave! The FAP cave? What's a FAP? We sail! We set sail! Get edge position. This would be a V3F. Yeah, okay, V3F. So the whole point of all this is to set V3F pause. Position of zero. Now, if we're on if we've already found basically if area pause equals des, okay, otherwise zero appears at edge of path and walks off screen. I do not know what a FAP is. And, oh, I think we also need direction. Yeah, we need compass direction too. Compass direction. V3F pause and compass direction D. Google FAP and go to images. I don't know about this. It's because it's a bad thing. Do I really want to be doing this right now on a live stream? I don't know. D. Oh, yeah. Pause equals there. We're setting a direction here. So, okay. Yeah, that should work there. And then if this, we're just going to go pause equals, or pause.set area size.width times a half, and area size.height times a third-ish, and then direction is north. Oh, this is area size.x. Area size dot y. Ah, thanks, Pedro. Thank you. I knew it. I knew it. I knew you were trying to troll me. What's up, Arcane? How you doing, man? So what I'm doing here is I'm making it so zero. Oh, this thing should be 0, 0. F there. So this screen, 0 should appear and walk north. Ah, it didn't work. Over here. Oh, probably because zero can't engage until after a minute. Yeah. Okay, yeah. So there, it's not going to work if we're starting right on this screen. But this, oh, it didn't work. It did not work. We should have seen zero right here. Okay, well, I'll save here. Why didn't we get zero there? Oh, because of this. Else, duh. Really, there's an animal called a mountain chicken and it's actually a frog? No way. That's exciting. You want to go catch one? Sounds fun. Still nothing. What's up with zero? Maybe he's still not engaged. There, now he's on for sure. He's engaged, he's appeared once, he should keep appearing. Yeah, there he is. Oh, nice, it worked. Cool. Yeah, okay, so I'm gonna run around the world and make sure he's still appearing. There he is. Cool. You can just follow him to the cave. I think his position could have started a little higher, though. What's up, Sean? It's crazy I'm here, man. Isn't my stream messed up or something? It looks like it's working fine here, except that it's eating so much CPU. It's crazy. Taxes done? High five, Pedro. Dude, that's a milestone. That's always a milestone in the year for me. I'm like, yes, the rest of the year is easy breezy. My taxes are done. You're going to get $400 back? Jealous. Jealous, man. I had to pay $700 this year. Yeah, cool. That worked. Except for maybe one more, one less. Yeah, that was pretty good. Okay, so he's indicating that, yeah, come on in here, man. Come into my cave. And then you go into his cave. There's nothing in the first one. But then in this one, we get the cactus pouch. So right here, we're going to find a cactus pouch. You pick up the cactus pouch. You use the cactus, and it displays a broken wall right here. And then Zero appears, sets down a bomb, breaks it open, and basically opens the entrance to dungeon number three for you. Dungeon number two, whatever it happens to be for your world. Okay, so good. Okay, check that in. That's basically just Zero appears outside his cave. Okay. So I want to draw the cactus pouches and add these in. I think I already did the item. No, I didn't do the cactus pouch. Well, that's weird. Okay, I got to do the cactus pouch then. So constants.h. Okay, item. We got sacks, diamonds, bomb containers, life containers. Oh, it's cactus container. That's right. And there's 9 of them. None of them have images yet. Oh. So first thing is to get some images for them. Why is the thingy red? What thingy are you talking about, man? Okay, so let's draw these cactus pouches. I'm gonna open up the HUD image and get an image for the cactus pouch drawn. Thinking of like a leather, like satchel type thing. But not like this awesome. I'm thinking like an old school, more like a leather pouch, I guess. This satchel's not, that's not like a, no. No! Leather pouch. Yeah. Yeah, like that, kind of. This is what I'm thinking you keep your cactuses in, something like that. Or that. Or that. That's pretty cool. All right, so I'm going to see what this would look like if I were to take this particular image and put it at a pixel art resolution. Okay, so let's clean it up, make it look cool, and then I want to try putting some cactuses kind of like coming out of it or something. Looks like a guitar, it does. Take one of these cactuses. I don't know. Let's try to look and see what this looks like before I call it. Does not look like a pouch. Oh, yeah. See you later, gaming artist. I stream every day, man. Just about every day. 5 days a week or so. Usually not as much on weekends. But yeah, I'll be back tomorrow. Same time, man. Okay, so I'm gonna save this as user slices, common HUD. Oh, this needs to be called. So what I've done here is I've just drawn a really crappy one, right, to start with, because everything changes when you put it in the game. So first, I always put things in the game, so you guys are like yelling at me to change the art. But just be patient, I got a process here. Watch the process unfold. Save for web. Oh no, I gotta turn on this. Name this. All right, so yeah, cactus container. Right name already in use. What? This says error, sprite name already in use. Doesn't even tell me a sprite name. Okay, the only one I added was this. There's no way there's two cactus containers. What happened? What happened? Oh, duh, I put them all in common. Damn it, that sucks. Look at all these files I gotta delete now. Shit. Oh, this is lame. Lame. Lame mistake. It's gonna take a few minutes here. Okay, that wasn't that so bad, actually. Okay, we're back to square one. Now let's re-export. This time, making damn sure it's in the right place. Not common, but HUD. User slices. Should be able to build here, and it should repack the textures. We should get no errors this time. And then we can finally get in the game and see how this pouch color size looks, and then I'll make it look cool. Okay, so I need to add a pouch to the player's inventory, of course. So we have one of them. Two of them. Alright, it didn't do the right image. Wonder why that is. Should be, oh, it's item cactus container. You thought it was only coming out for Retro VGS? What? That's crazy, man. It was a possibility for Retro VGS, but then Retro VGS never ever came to fruition. But yeah, it's always been a PC game, man. Yeah, it's always been PC, Mac, and Linux. And iOS was confirmed during the Kickstarter phase. OK, Okay, yeah, so that looks really stupid, but at least I can see now that the colors, they're not going to jam with that super highlight. And okay, let's draw a better cactus pouch. That's crazy, Sean. It's crazy. I can't believe. I'm thinking of drawing like a smaller version of a cactus, first of all. Yeah. Oh, I drew it on the wrong layer. Damn it. There we go. Okay, get rid of this cactus layer. We got the pouch layer now. Okay, let's draw a better pouch. I'm just gonna draw this from scratch. Can we learn to do what's right? What's wrong? You did. Oh, thanks, Sean. It's crazy. I appreciate that, man. Pre-ordered. That's cool. Well, if you pre-ordered at the $16 version, that means you get the game when it comes out later this year. If you pre-ordered the $32 version, you can play it right now and play the beta. But yeah, man, I'm excited for you and I appreciate it because every dollar that comes in helps me develop the game, man. So I appreciate it a lot. And I hope you enjoy it too. What's up, T8 Cub? Tate Cub? This is looking better, right? Without this craziness over here. Just get rid of that. This is the pouch. Re-render. Okay, this time make sure it's in HUD. Yeah, HUD. See how that looks. Okay, cool. That's kind of nice, but it's too small. So I'll make it twice as big. No. They're definitely taller. A lot bigger. Okay. So let's make this wider, taller. Let's try that. See about how that looks. Oh yeah. You get a Steam key right now if you did the $32 version. But otherwise, you get one when it comes out later this year. So yeah, you should get an email from Humble if you pre-order the $32 version right now. And otherwise, you get an email from me later this year. Either ways, I'll email you and ask you what name you want in the credits, because you just got your name in the credits, man. You can put whatever you want. You can put Sean is crazy. Credits to Sean is crazy. Thanks, Sean is crazy. You helped make Songbringer a reality. You did, man. You did. You are. That's better. It's kind of looking more pouch-like. Except for the top. The top is looking a little funny. Maybe you can get more of like a string on top. Like imagining something like this. Whoops. Whoops. Oh my God. Nice. So, for anybody just joining the stream, or you re-fast forwarding through this video or whatever, what I'm working on now is this is Zero's cave. Zero is this NPC who's quite mysterious. He's your spirit guide, actually. He has a lot to do with the cactuses. When you eat the cactuses, I don't want to give away too much, but anyways, this is Zero's cave. And I'm working on cactus pouches, so this is it. Yeah, that looks better. It kind of looks like a string. Looks very cactus pouchy. It needs some text though. We need some text for these cactus pouches. It's good though. I like the art. The art's good enough as it is. Like it. Keeping it. Maybe actually one pixel like that. Okay, so when it goes and does its phase gear and shows you your gear and all that, there's this one bit where it says, if it's like one of these things, show me a quantity, like a bomb container. Is cactus container item. And strings English, we need the item cactus container. How many cactuses do you get per pouch? I'm thinking like only two or three. Start with three. Cool, we got a description, but it still doesn't have the quantity. I guess I gotta do its own custom thing. Displayable quantity, that's it. Wait, displayable quantity. Oh, get displayable quantity. If this is a cactus container. Count the cactus containers, and that's the displayable quantity. Right, cool, we got two of them. But it would be better if the art was on the left so it doesn't cover up the number. So, let me rework this. He's crazy right now. He's giving free parking away, like, everywhere. Free parking is just because you're watching the stream. You got free parking. It's like, you know, free parking. Like, you pass go, you get free parking. You just get free points. Because Bob Food likes giving away points. He's quite nice. He's very, very well-mannered individual. Okay, yeah, there. Now it looks a little better. I see the numbers behind that, so you can see what it is, though. Cactus pouch. Cool, I have two cactus pouches. Okay, so the next thing is to make sure when you have cactuses, it clamps your number of cactuses based on how many cactus containers you have. So this is the clamp function. Clamp, 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 clamp. The item max, that's the thing. If it's a bomb, if it's a cactus, yeah, you can get it. So Sean is crazy. You can get a free, Steam key by saving up your points and then raffling them. So it's, you don't get it every time, but if you save up for 1,000 points, then you can raffle it for a 25% chance to get another beta key. So you could always save up enough points, and it takes like every minute counts as 1 point. So you need to watch 1,000 minutes, and then you raffle off the points and you win if you get that 25% thing. So, and also if you save up for 4,000 points, you get a free, you get guaranteed Steam key, and you could always give that to a friend or do whatever you want with it, 'cause you already got your own Steam key. It's not guaranteed, though. It's not guaranteed that you win, but you got that, like I said, 25% chance, and then it's 50% at 2,000 points, and then 100% all the way at 4,000 points. Yeah, I know. Tika Cheek just got, like, used. And the thing is, if you wait for the 4,000 point one, though, it's guaranteed, so you can always do that. Just save up your points even more. So now I have two of these cactus pouches. If I set my cactuses, let's say I try and cheat the game, and I say, oh, I got 30 cactuses. It should limit that now to 6. No, it still is 30. Wonder why I did that. Constant CPP. Yeah, we have a max quantity of one cactus container. Oh, max quantity of cactuses. Fifteen. Yeah, so we need, that's gonna be three. That's the number per. Three cacti per container, and then I want to make this clear also on the bomb. I don't know. Oh, 63. Sorry. That was right. 15 is the price, but three is the maximum quantity. Three cacti per container. And this bomb is, okay, bombs per container. I guess I should do a cacti per container here. Just make this super duper clear. Okay, cacti per container. Cool, now we got a limited, right? Yeah, T, you'll get there, man. You get 4,000 points, then a free key. Give it to somebody. Sell it on eBay. Do whatever you want with it. Okay, so it's recompiling everything there, and this is the, now that that's a constant, that's pretty good. So it's pretty clear that, okay, we got three cactuses per container, or whatever this value happens to be. Now, when I go into the game this time, it should properly clamp my amount of cactuses, which is currently set to 30, and it should clamp that down to 6, which is 3 times the number of containers I have to. And that's pretty much how cactus containers work. All it does is just allow you to have more cactuses if you can find them. What's up, Ziak? It's going well, man. Oh, well, one more thing. We need to mimic how count bomb containers works. And there's a couple places where count bomb containers needs to be, yeah. We need to count cactus containers. So it's not just gonna reward the player with a cactus container or with a cactus until the player has obtained at least one cactus container. Same thing, where else? Oh, what? Oh yeah, cactus, bomb, yeah, that's right. Oh, we're gonna need a special item flux. Just comment this out for a second. Okay, so I'm testing out the maximum here. It's just gonna set It should reset my cactuses to 6. Alright, I started with... Right, 6, nice. I started with 30, but it clamped it appropriately because I have 2 cactus pouches. If I had more cactus pouches, let's say I had every single cactus pouch in the game, that would be 9 times 3 or 27. It would still be less than 30. You never have 30 cactuses anymore. But that's all right because they all give you health. They're important items. Yeah, 27. Sweet. This is working. Now if I had no cactus pouches, no cactuses. Let's say, let's put this back. Okay, let's keep it at 0. Even though my cactus are set at 30, it clamps it every time. That's cool. Next, I want to place the cactus container. So, let's do that. In Zero's cave, I want to take away the entrance tile. It's going to automatically put it on the ground, so that's good. You just need to make sure it's placing that. So I guess we can go auto Z. I guess we can call this just level Z. Doors, home, sword, entrance B, secret, interest, entrance, stores, ship. This one has flagged entrance. This is probably a good place to put this. So if this, I started writing cactus. Constance is underground entrance. And this is the entrance area. And this Z is first swordless Z. Then items that push back. Okay, cactus container one. This is where you find the first cactus container. You're preparing for green light? Awesome, Teak! Yeah, dude! Congratulations! Prepping for green light. Good for you, man. Definitely let me know the link, post, let me know all about it. So I don't have any cactus containers, correct? And damn, there's no item. Okay, let me save here though. I thought this would be, let's see if that gets to there. A swarm-based puzzle and exploration game, cool. Oh, see, it never even hit this breakpoint. Oh no, it's supposed to be level Z. If level Z is the first sword of the Z. Right, cool. We hit the breakpoint that time. Hopefully we have this item on the floor. Okay, it's not on the floor, but it made it like this. And I don't have my sword here. this I need to have the sword here still. I am hungry, Bafu. I am hungry. I'm very hungry. Cool, players can create their own maps and texture packs too. Sweet. So yeah, I'm gonna wrap it up here and call this a day. Got a lot done already. Placing the cactus container is now in here. So this is great. Made a lot of progress today. There's already this entrance to this cave is super cool. If you encounter Zero, if you get him to engage, he'll appear on this screen and show you that he wants you to walk inside this cave. That's cool too. The area, the pattern for this outdoor cave is all written nicely. Did some scroll work or these runes here on the edges and made these statues look more 3D. And now I'm working on these caves on the inside. The whole point here is for you to encounter this guy named Zero. And Zero gives you, you find the cactus pouch here. You get the cactuses for the first time in the game. You use the cactus for the first time and this wall appears back here, or this cracks in the wall appear back here. Zero places down a bomb. So it shows you that using the cactuses can reveal secret walls. So that's it. That's what I'm working on. And then once you actually go into that cave after he blows it up, you're in the alternate dungeon, which is mostly puzzle based. So my next steps are to make this so it's not inside a container here. I also need to make sure the player does have the sword still. You don't lose the sword until you go inside this puzzle dungeon. And yeah, that's some of the next things. So I'm done for today's stream, and I'm gonna go get some food. So thanks for everybody for watching. Appreciate y'all. Hope you all have a great day. Good job on Ludum Dare, everybody. Some of the games are looking great. And Teak, definitely let me know when Swarmonian Explorer is ready to be clicked yes on the green light. So catch you guys next time.